Hello everybody, Hooded Cobra Commander 788 here, and this is the Rare Vlog. We don't do this very often. We don't just sit down and talk, but we should. We should, every once in a while, just sit down and communicate and just talk about stuff that's going on. And that's hard to do sometimes within the weekly video reviews, but I think it's important. Now, these in-between videos, they don't take away anything from the weekly video reviews, but just kind of as a bonus, I think it's good that we just sit down and have a more general discussion every once in a while. So that's what we're going to try now, and I've got some notes because I didn't want to forget what I was going to talk about. So I did want to talk about how the channel is doing, and I wanted to talk about the future. So the channel right now, we have about 2,600 subscribers, which I think is great. It has taken us almost exactly 3 years to get there, and that is, to me, fantastic. We are bringing more people in. We are reigniting passion for G.I. Joe that some people may have forgotten. I can see the comments. I can see how excited people are getting about it, and that really is heartwarming to me. I love seeing that. And now the channel has changed. It's changed a lot in the few years that we've done this. If you look at those early videos, you know, what we do now is very different from what I did then. But it's not just the videos. I think the scope and the purpose of the channel has changed. Now, when I first started doing reviews, I had two purposes. The first one was to share my collection. And kind of show my collection as it grows. Because I was a novice collector, I was really just getting started out, and I really only accumulated a few things, but these reviews would be kind of document my journey as a collector, as I start out new and not knowing very much, and grow in experience. So I wanted to share that, plus I get more enjoyment out of having the stuff if I'm able to share it with someone. I get a lot more enjoyment out of that than if I just stick it up on a shelf and nobody who doesn't come into my house ever gets to see it. So sharing these things with you makes me enjoy it that much more. The second purpose was to learn more about the toys. Now, these are toys that I hadn't played with in more than 30 years. My memory is not that great. So doing the reviews has been a great excuse to do some research and learn more about the toys. And I get more enjoyment out of that, out of the toys for that reason as well. So that's kind of the impetus that got us started. But things have changed. I mean, we have a growing audience, we have the capability of doing more, and I feel like now we should be maybe a little more ambitious than that. What I'd like to do with the channel going forward is I'd like to bring more of the community together, and I want to promote talent, because I like to see talented people recognized and rewarded for their hard work. And so these are things that I would like to accomplish with this channel, in addition to sharing the toys and reigniting people's passion for G.I. Joe. I want the G.I. Joe community to be noticed. I want the G.I. Joe community to be noticed by people outside of the community, by people who may not have any special interest in G.I. Joe. I want them to see what we're doing here and want to pay attention to that. I want them to think that they need to keep an eye on what's going on in the G.I. Joe community, because there's some real passion there. There's some talented people doing some great work there. And I want people who aren't in the community to still feel like this community is important and they want to know what's going on there. Now, we have a smaller community than a lot of other fandoms. If you compare it to Transformers, if you compare it to Star Wars, G.I. Joe is pretty small, but G.I. Joe was the part of the childhood of millions of people, and many of those people have forgotten. Through our work here, we can remind some of those people how much they used to love this stuff, and so that's one of the things that I want to do. Now, in the YouTube world, G.I. Joe channels are pretty small. There are channels on YouTube with millions of subscribers. And even if you narrow it down to the toy-focused section of YouTube, G.I. Joe is still pretty small. And Pixel Dan has about 180,000 subscribers. And even if you only focus on retro toy-focused YouTube channels, G.I. Joe channels are still pretty small. If you look at Retro Blasting, they have about 22,000 subscribers. At this time, as it stands right now, there isn't any G.I. Joe focused channel that has anything close to 100,000 subscribers. I mean, that would be huge in the toy focused YouTube community. But I'm not sure that goal is quite attainable, at least not for the foreseeable future. The way it appears to me is that channels that have a broader focus tend to do better than channels that have a narrower focus. Now that's a little bit counterintuitive, because you would think that channels that with a broader focus, that don't focus on a specific toy line or a specific fandom, would lose out on views when those channels post videos that part of their viewership isn't interested in. For instance, if a channel posts a Transformers video, but a large part of their fan base is into Star Wars. Well, the Star Wars fans are not going to watch a Transformers video, so they're more likely to just skip it. Now, that's what you would think would happen, but it doesn't appear to be the case. Channels that focus on a specific fandom are niche, and it can be a big niche if the fandom is large. But channels that focus only on vintage toys within a fandom are a niche within a niche. So it's really a smaller range of potential viewers that we are trying to attract. So like fans of, say, Voltron, they don't have any reason to watch my videos because they're never going to see Voltron in my videos. But they will subscribe to Retro Blasting, because even if only 1 out of 10 videos is about Voltron, at least they will see some Voltron. So a channel like Retro Blasting with a broader appeal like that has a greater potential number of viewers that they can attract. That being the case, I think there is kind of a ceiling for the popularity of a channel like mine, and if I were to guess at what the top end of that would be, where the ceiling would be, I would guess about 10,000 subscribers. And at least as I calculate it right now, I don't think there is any G.I. Joe focused channel that has 10,000 subscribers yet. I think we're all under that right now. However, I think it might be possible to push that ceiling a little bit higher. Now, how would we do this? We would do this by making sure that our videos are entertaining. They need to be informative. I mean, they've got to have some depth. Otherwise, I mean, if I did videos that didn't have any information in them and that were just only, you know, popcorn entertainment, I would lose interest in them. I've got to produce videos that, in my estimation, have some depth, videos that I would want to watch. I mean, this is also, you have to consider, this is a visual entertainment medium. So we can't just sit here and read technical manuals in front of the camera. Nobody would watch that. There has to be some kind of entertainment factor involved. I think it's possible to crack that ceiling a little bit if we can give viewers a little extra reason to want to subscribe and tune in and watch. Now, if any channel, if any G.I. Joe focused channel is going to break through that ceiling, that channel should be Kevin, obviously. It should be FormBX257. I mean, FormBX257 right now has about 6,400 subscribers, and he's been doing it the longest. He has the greatest store of knowledge. He has a smooth style that's easy to watch. But for me, coming up behind Kevin, there's a different perspective. I want the community as a whole to succeed and get noticed. If Kevin succeeds and if Kevin breaks through that ceiling, then I succeed because the community succeeds when that happens. I'm fine being the noisy cricket. All right, that can be my role. I'm okay being the obnoxious guy at the party that not everybody likes. Because when I make that noise and when I get everybody's attention, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say, hey, I'm gonna look at the point in the direction of Kevin and say, hey, look at what the great stuff that guy's doing. And look over here, I mean, look at Half the Battle. Look at the great things that Half the Battle are doing. Look at G.I. Joburg. G.I. Joburg is fantastic. You don't want to miss out on that stuff. Look at JoeFan82. Great stuff coming from JoeFan82. And they, all these other G.I. Joe-focused content creators who are doing some great work, some very entertaining work, and very informative videos, and videos worth watching. I have no problem taking on the role of being a noisemaker that gets people's attention, because I'm going to use that attention, hopefully, to strengthen the community, to broaden the reach of the community, and to make sure that the whole community benefits from that. If this channel attains any success at all, then I'm not going to do it alone. I've said it all along that we're in this together, and so as I move forward, I'm taking all of you with me. So as we move forward, as we gain more subscribers, as we gain a greater audience, as we get more success, I want to take Kevin and Timmer and G.I. Joburg and JoeFan82 and everyone else on YouTube who cares about this stuff and say, you know, let's go. Let's all go together. Let's go forward all together and conquer the world. And, you know, we don't have to live out there on islands just doing it ourselves. We are in this together, and working together, we can build something bigger than we could ever build on our own. So I want to make sure that you understand that that includes you that are watching this. Everyone who subscribes and watches the videos, you are the community. Every time you watch a video, every time you comment, every time you share it, every time you turn someone on to what we're doing, you are expanding and strengthening the community, and you are bringing to fruition what we are working toward. We are going to write our names, our own names, into G.I. Joe history. And in G.I. Joe history, my name may only be a footnote, but it's going to be a footnote. And all of us together, we're going to be a whole lot more than a footnote. In addition to, you know, trying to create the best review that I can do, I also try to be entertaining. And I know that not everybody likes that. Often they say that they don't like that. But the fact is that that's not going to change. I'm going to do my best not only to inform, but to entertain as well. Because not only do I want to immerse you in G.I. Joe goodness, I also want viewers to need to watch the videos about toys that they don't necessarily care about. Not everybody cares about every single G.I. Joe action figure. And so if I'm doing a review of a figure or a vehicle that most people don't even remember, and even if they do remember, they never really liked it, you still gotta watch the video review of that, because in my reviews, in my videos, anything could happen. I could introduce a new segment, we could have a guest, we could have a cameo from another YouTube personality. Anything could happen. I could get into a lethal battle with a robot. I could go to doggy heaven. I could be sent to hell. Anything. You don't want to miss any videos, because if you do, you may miss something that has implications for the future. Something surprising, something monumental, something that you didn't expect. Yeah, I do. I want to make some noise. I want to make so much noise that people outside of the G.I. Joe community hear it. I want them to take notice. And when they do, yeah, I'm going to say, look at Kevin. Look at G.I. Joburg. Look at Timmer. Look at these guys. Look at JoeFan doing modern G.I. Joe toy reviews. This is the stuff that they're producing now. You don't want to miss out on that stuff too. There is stuff going on here, and there's a lot of passion in this relatively small community, and that's what I'm going to do. And that's what I strive to do every week. If the G.I. Joe YouTube community is going to break through the 10,000 subscriber ceiling and climb closer to the 100,000 subscriber territory, what we need to do is to produce content now that is worthy of 100,000 subscribers. We got to do our best now, not wait till we have reached the great pinnacles of success. We need to be worthy of that success now. And so that is worth every effort that we can put into it. And that is worth, you know, banding together and making sure that not only is my channel noticed, but everything that everybody else is doing G.I. Joe related on YouTube is noticed as well. But that means I have to keep pushing myself to get better. It means I need to call upon the support of the community. It means I need to make the final product more polished. I need to have better equipment. I need to get better toys to review. I need to learn new skills. I always have to keep pushing myself forward and pushing myself to learn more and to do better and to have greater connections with the community at large. But I can promise you that I'm working at that every day. Some of you have helped me, and for that I have more gratitude than I can express. But I just want to remind everybody that this channel is not just about me. It never has been. It's about us. And I know that not everybody's going to continue on this journey. I know that I'm not everybody's cup of tea, and I'm going to annoy people sometimes, and that's just a fact, and I've learned to accept that. That doesn't bother me one bit. So, you know, anyone is welcome to jump off the train anytime they want to. But the train's not stopping. We're going forward. Never go backward. We only go forward. And those who do choose to go with us, I think, are going to be part of something special. Something big, something that will be remembered long after we're done. I think people are going to discover this stuff and marvel at what we built here. And so that's what I want to do. And that's where this channel is going now. It's a more ambitious goal than what I had when I started. But you know what? I think it's a worthy goal. So right now, JoeCon is coming up, and what I'm trying to do right now is accumulate as big a war chest as I can. Plenty of cash for the dealer floor, and it looks like it won't be quite as much as I had to spend last year, but I need to stock up on items to review next year. JoeCon has become kind of vital as a, you know, part of the process of doing these reviews, because that's where I get a lot of the stuff that I end up reviewing through the year. So that's priority number one. Priority number two after JoeCon is to upgrade my camera. This camera has served its purpose valiantly for quite a while now, but there are some things that I need to do in the future that this camera just can't quite do. I need a camera with more features. I need a camera with a slightly better quality. And so that is the next goal. So supporters, those of you who have supported me and continue to do so, I want to assure you your contributions are going straight into the show. You may not see some of the results right away, but that's because I'm being a little more ambitious now. I have bigger plans that will take longer to play out, but over the long term, my hope is that you will notice an increased quality over time in these videos, and your contributions are an integral and important part of that. I want to do more collaborations. I want to work with other content creators because I really want to give you guys a good quality, entertaining, and informative show every week. And if we can keep doing that and keep pounding away every week and keep trying to improve every week, then we, all of us, are going to do something big here, something far bigger than I ever dreamed of doing when I first started this channel. And whether we succeed or fail, we're going to try. And I think it's worthy of our best efforts. So we're going to try our best, and we're going to try to build something that people remember long after we're gone. Now, there's one other thing I wanted to talk about. I recently announced that eventually this project of reviewing every vintage G.I. Joe toy will end. When the last G.I. Joe toy has been reviewed, then this project is done. And I've even announced which toy will be the final one to be reviewed, and that'll be Rock and Roll version 2. It makes me feel better to know that there is an attainable goal to work toward. That motivates me, and so that keeps me motivated and focused. It's important. It was important to set that parameter for the channel. Now, of course, I could have just announced that. I could have done, you know, a vlog like this, or just announced it at the beginning or at the end of a review video, you know, or I could be killed by Robo Joe, regenerate, go to doggy heaven, and then go to hell, and then return in a bolt of lightning. Instead of just announcing it in a video like this, we did things a little bit more dramatically. That's just kind of how we do things around here. So what would I do after G.I. Joe? Well, I mean, I have some ideas, but none of it is certain yet. I mean, there's a possibility that I could do nothing. I could just retire. But you know, the other toy lines interest me. There's nothing in my life that even comes close to G.I. Joe, though. So I have some ideas, but it's not quite certain. That's a long ways off. It's too far down the road, and there's still a lot of years of G.I. Joe left to do. So I'm not going to worry about that right now. I've still got a lot of G.I. Joe left to look at, and so I'm going to just keep pounding away every week toward our goal of looking at everything. That's all I really wanted to say. Other than, once again, thank you. Thank you for sitting through this super long video. Thank you for watching every week. Thank you for your communications. One of the best things about this has been communicating with you. And, you know, I've tried to keep up with the comments and private messages. You know, I do want this channel to grow. But as the channel continues to grow, it's going to be harder and harder for me to keep up with comments, with emails, with private messages, and things like that. And already it's becoming difficult to keep up with. I mean, if I sometimes get comments and get emails and messages when it's not a convenient time for me to reply. I do have a regular job. I do have family obligations, so I'm not always in a position to reply when I receive it. And then sometimes when I get back to it, you know, it's not easy to go back and find the one that I intended to reply to, but I wasn't able to. So I apologize about that. But that's regrettable. It kind of makes me sad, because one of the best things about doing this project is you. I do want the channel to continue to grow. I do recognize that communicating with my viewers will be more difficult as that happens, but as much as I can and as long as I can, I am going to try to keep having like good one-on-one personal relationships with my viewers as much as I possibly can. So thank you for your patience, thank you for your indulgence, thank you for being here. And I will let you all go for now. We've got a lot coming up. We've got a big thing going on for the month of April. I hope you like it, and I hope you like the direction of the channel going forward. And for those of you who choose to stick around, let's do something special. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.